Hi guys, Harry Sunday here, letting you know that there's a apparel company that supports the game that you love. It's called There Is Only One Football.com, guys. They've got all sorts of stuff, from caps, t-shirts, water bottles, all sorts of accessories, even for your mobile phone, all that sporting stuff you can wear anywhere you want to wear it, guys. That's right. And don't forget the website it's on, thereisonlyonefootball.com.
Check it out. If you're listening right now, I've got some great news for you guys. Some people won't be happy. Some people will be happy. Some people won't be happy. You got your opinions. That's fine. Here we go. Check it out. Hey, the cup of life. This is the one. Now is the time. Don't ever stop. We shouldn't know. Gotta be strong. We shouldn't know. Right from the top. And when you feel the heat, the world is at your feet. No one can hold you back if you really want it. Here we go. I see it in your eyes. You want the cup of life. Night to days, here you're gonna get it. Do you really want it? Tell me right now, people! Here we go. Ali, ali, ali. Good, good, go. Ali, ali, ali. Tonight's the night. We're gonna celebrate. Here we go. We are the people, we are the passion, we are the history. We come from the NSL, and that's where the NSL is right now, guys. We're going to be back in the NSL very shortly, guys. Thank you, guys. Right now, I just thought I'd come online. If you listen to me right now, guys, I thought I'd come online because I got some great news today, and a lot of people aren't going to be happy, of course. I'm just going to make sure a couple of people get on right now. As you can see, we have a brand new system here. It's looking fantastic. You may be seeing on my right, on my left-hand side, on my right-hand side, I think it is, FA opens expressions of interest for a national football second tier. As far as I'm concerned, it is an NSL. It's an NSL. As you can see, these clubs, these boys on the front here, they're former NSL clubs, guys. Of course, you can see one of the South Melbourne captains there, of course. I'm not going to mention names, but I'm just going to make sure that I get this message out today so everyone can listen to what's happening. And we are putting our hands up. Yes, footballers are putting their hands up to get involved in the NSL, or the second tier, if you want to call it that, guys. We want to be involved. We are talking to people about this, and hopefully it's going to be an amazing journey through the NSL, guys, well, second tier, if you want to call that as well. So let me just get onto the other site there to actually post some stuff so people can actually listen to this as well. I'd like to read a few little things from the excerpt on the news as well, guys. So as you can see, our sponsors, CCD Lawyers, and There Is Only One Football. Don't forget, guys, as you can see, my left-hand side, right-hand side, these are fantastic shirts that were worn by the NSL clubs. We're hoping that they wear them in the second division. It's the second coming. As far as I'm concerned, as the NSL, you can scream as much as you like, guys, but they're the clubs that made the game. They're the clubs that actually were the foundation clubs of the first competition, national competition in this country, and that's what we're looking for right now. So if you clubs are looking at these shirts, There Is Only One Football, the of course, the thereisonlyonefootball.com on the bottom there, guys. If you want to get on there and you want to talk to someone about getting these shirts as supporters for your second division or the second NSL coming of the NSL, They're available now, guy, on There's Only One Football. That's where they're available. I'm just going right now to the former supporter sites to put this information up as well. We've got the information up. So if you're listening right now, please check out these shirts. You can buy them online. There is only one football, guys. Have a look at these amazing shirts, guys. You will not find this quality anywhere. So get on. There's only one football, guys. So I'm just getting on to our... we got this song specifically for the Matildas. They're all banging tonight. She bangs. Mary Fowler. I'm in love with you, Mary Fowler. My God, this is for you, love. Hey, check it out. Hey. Talk to me. Tell me your name. You blow me up. Cause it's all the same. You lit the fuse and now you're ticking away like a bomb. Yeah, baby. Talk to me. Tell me the news. We're in the yacht for a pair of shoes. We're going dancing till the band goes home. Now you know that's right, Mary Fowler. Oh God, we love you. Hey! Well, if it's Lady Luck, get you on the mind. We're gonna rock this town alive. I better... Mary! It's your song, love! It's our weather! Highway, gentlemen! Footballers is live tonight from all over the world! Bangs, she bangs. Oh, baby, when she moves, she moves. I go crazy cause she looks like a flower. That's Mary. Sings like a bee. Like every girl. Welcome everyone tonight, guys. Footballers, we are the way. We are the power. We are the way. We are the soccer. We are the game. It's our way, the highway. Gentlemen, my God, man, Peter. I'm sure that I'll be on New Faces very shortly, of course, as you can hear that song, my God, man. What a night it's been. What a few 3 days we've had, gentlemen. And actually, we've been going on a roller coaster ride, Kat. And, of course, we've got Tony Goodman tonight and Peter Katholos from New South Wales. Good evening, gentlemen. Well done. I tell you what, you guys, we've been on a massive roller coaster ride. After that Ireland game, we've been up, we've been down, we've been up with Peter. I tell you what, mate, these Gillers are giving us a nervous bloody breakdown, of course.
Mate, it is what it is. I mean, it's World Cup, mate. It's, exciting times. Good win the other day. That was a great, great result. But don't talk to me about that coach, mate. Give me a break. He's hopeless. He's hopeless.
Let me. You know what I call him? Actually, I've been watching some reruns of these superhero shows, and I looked at Batman and I said to myself, "Hang on, man. The guy's the Riddler. He's the Riddler, mate. The Riddler in that bloody film, mate. We're going to call him the Riddler. He's riddling all the time." Tony, what do you think, mate? You've been to the games too. You've been to a couple of games. But I tell you what, mate, the Matildas have given us heart attacks, heartbreak. What do you reckon?
Oh, look, it's I think with Sam Kerr being out, it's probably thrown the chemistry out a little bit. But that's for others to step up, then, isn't it? You know, he's just not going to be there forever. And I think we've uncovered some, great performances like Mary Fowler. Haley Russo and Gorry at the back. They leaders step up. So if Sam's great for the last few games, fantastic. But their performance the other night was first class. I didn't think Canada really played anywhere near their best either, which helped. But, doesn't matter. We're next to the round of 16, so that's all that matters.
Now, Peter, as I said, I call the guy the Riddler. Mate, the things he says, some of the things he tries to answer, is this guy the – mate, the guy's like going around in circles, the Riddler. I mean, you've heard some of the things in the last few days, eh?
Mate, he's a car salesman. That's what he is.
Jesus Christ, mate. Mate, you could sell me the Sydney Harbour Bridge and I'll bloody believe the bastard, that's for sure. Yeah, I tell you what, you know. But
he knows all his technical jargon. He's probably been reading those bloody textbook, manuals. But the girls are good luck to them. I mean, we hope they do well. And the other day was a great performance. But look, they have to step it up. They really have to step it up. I'm watching the England team last night. Oh, mate, they are a super team. Let me tell you, they beat that Chinese mob quite easy. And if we're going to do really well, they have to step it up. I think the Denmark game is going to be quite a tough game. Let's see what happens.
What a coincidence that is. What an absolute coincidence that is. That is weird. But let me say, I want to go back to the I want to go back to the, of course, back to the Ireland game, of course. We checked it out last week. We had a look at it. And then, of course, the girls didn't. They were finding their feet, trying to sort of like find a system where they're playing well together and stuff like that. But honestly, that we're going to go to the Nigeria game right now. That Nigeria game, that wasn't the Matildas, mate. That was some kind of other team thinking, you know, these number 40 in the world. Nigeria, number 40 in the world. The soccer is a what, 11 or something? Number 11 or even a bit number 4 or something? I mean, that is ridiculous to be able to sort of like, is it that this thing is basically, Peter, I'll get to Peter first. Is it sort of the load on their shoulders that they're carrying the nation in the country? Do you think it's affecting them that, you know, that the big it's a massive expectation to make the final?
Look, like I said before from the start, I'm watching, you know, both of those games. I mean, they put pressure on themselves. You know, against Nigeria, they gave the ball away so many times it wasn't funny. And then the game versus the other day when they won the game against Canada, they actually held possession a lot better.
Yes,
they didn't give the ball away as often, and their mistakes were limited. So look, they've improved, which is great. But they're going to step up even further for the next game. You know, possession is crucial. You know, their defense it needs to tighten up. I think they're a bit you know, at the back they can be caught out. So look, you know, they're improving, and let's hope we do well for the next game.
And then going to Tony right now, Tony, we all saw the game, and the one point in that Nigeria game was that one of the girls is going forward, you know, we're going back to our goals. And, I mean, did you see that header right into the girl's path and she scores a goal? Now, that we're talking here, you're talking here for God, you're supposed to be in a World Cup, you're talking about double the effort to stop them from scoring, and she gives it to them right in front of them. That's the thing, Tony. So these are the mistakes that we don't want to see in the next game. That's the other thing.
Yeah, look, it's lack of communication, also situational awareness. You know, as a defender, you know, you're looking to put the ball back to the keeper, but you want to make sure there's no one right up your backside as you're doing it, because you're going to go into awareness. But then again, it may have come down to communication. You know, there was always a call years ago, you know, like man on, or just some your communication. You got 2 meters, you know, that sort of thing. But you don't have to look behind you. You just got an idea where the ball is because you're being told where it is. But I think that game, they just seemed, it was disjointed. A lot of the passing as well, it wasn't weighted properly. It was either too fast or too slow, you know, because sometimes passing can be a tactical situation where you can draw players towards a certain area at the same time so we can open up spaces. But they didn't get it right that night. The chemistry just wasn't there.
Somebody also said to me, and you know the guy too, Peter, oh, my God, what happened that night? Okay, we just spoke about the Nigeria game. They had to improve. Boy, did they improve on the other night against, of course, against. We're talking about a lot of revenge here. A lot of revenge, because we played them at the Olympics and we got done. We got thrown out of there. But to come back the way they did, knowing that, of course, they would have known about the Olympics, and, of course, we got done and we got thrown out of the Olympic tournament, of course. But then someone spoke, a former Socceroo, he got really upset. I was surprised. And you know this guy, Peter, you know him. This has to come from somebody really high up. And he said, and this is what I couldn't believe. Now, he says, why aren't they playing in their green and gold? This is disgusting. Guess who said it? Scotty Chipperfield. Oh, my God. He saw the outfits. Are they Australian outfits, Peter? You saw those outfits. Were they lime green or something? What were they? Ice cream colour?
It's a good point. I mean, it's a good point. I mean, the Aussie colours are green and gold. I mean, everyone's used to that. Yeah, that's interesting. I mean, I saw it, and I didn't say anything, but yeah, you sort of think, what happened to the green and gold? But look, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. I mean, maybe we didn't want to clash with the other team. I'm not sure. And maybe they want to sell some of those away jerseys. I don't know.
Maybe they've sold out the green and gold, and they've got the girls wearing them to try and sell these now. That's the other thing.
Well, that's it, mate. It's marketing.
It's marketing. That's right. So that's the thing. But I tell you what, I didn't mind those outfits on the girls. Something a bit different. But I mean, did the Socceroos, we didn't wear them. At the boys didn't wear that. They wore something different. I think it was the blue outfit at the time. The blue outfit in we had the blue outfit in Qatar actually. Now, Tony, I want to say something that going back to the Nigeria game, and apparently one of the biggest names of the NSL, of course, Robbie Slater, stated that this coach is hopeless. Well, here we go. I'm going to quote him. This coach is hopeless. Instead of bringing an attacker on, he brought a centre-half on the game when we needed to score a goal to actually draw the game. So he brought a centre-half, put Paul Kinghorn on. I mean, Peter would probably think himself, this is probably wrong. As a coach, Peter, yourself, would you have brought an attacker on or a centre-half?
Mate, listen, I've said before and I'll say it again. This guy is not, look, Tony mentioned Alan Stajic.
Yes.
Now, Alan, if Alan was there, you know, we would, you know, this is a guy that's a good coach. This guy, look, what he says, it doesn't make sense. He talks rubbish. I mean, anyone that knows football would think, what's he talking about? Is he for real? He just doesn't make sense what he is on about. And I can imagine now in the dressing room, giving instructions to the girls, mate, it'd be all over the place.
And Tony, the expressions on the ground. What was he doing? His expressions on the ground, the way he's dancing and doing things like, mate, I want to get the guy to dance the Macarena with me in the Caribbean Kings, mate. He's that bloody good about that, you know? Jesus, Tony.
Very animated, yeah, obviously. I'm just wondering about the strip that we wore. We did it is the away team for that game, though, even though it's on our home soil. Because, I mean, the opposition gets a choice of their kit and they can refuse the away teams. Like if we, say, play in the A-League and we go to Sydney, we want to wear our red strip, they get the right to refuse it. So I'm just wondering if that was the case, but it did seem very weird to wear a strip. But then again, was it one of these weird psychological things that, you know, we don't rock up in the green and gold and they're a little bit confused by that and it takes their mind off the game? Mm. Try and think outside the box of some weird garbage, but it wouldn't surprise me from him. You know, wear something different, mix it up.
and I put my foot in it too, Peter, like we said before we got on the air, and I said the greatest Matildas coach ever. Which way will it go? We don't know. We don't know which way will it go. But the thing is, if he gets that job done, if we go all the way with this bloke, people are going to say, well, we won, and they don't talk anymore. And you know what it's like, eh? Everybody shuts up about a coach that gets a job done. But the thing is, if he gets it wrong now, he dodged the bullet the other day. He dodged the bullet. If we got done against Canada, he'd have to bloody pack his bags and leave Australia straight away, to tell you the truth. But this guy, anyway, he goes on and on.
Anyway, let's hope the girls just play for the green and gold. They give 100%, 150%. Let's hope that his instructions go through one ear and go through out through the other. And
mate,
look, that, look, I got to tell you, I mean, at the end of the day, it's individual performances are gonna win the game. And the thing is, you know, talking about the coach or whatever, it really is not important at the moment.
I mean, that's right.
At the end of the day, it's all about the performance out there and the individuals, how badly they want it.
Yes.
They're playing for the green and gold. They're playing for their country. You know, once you're out there, you know, you're out there to give your best shot.
Yes.
You know, all these instructions that I'm pretty sure this guy would be, you know, documenting whatever. Look, you know, they all go out the window once you're on the park, because you know you got to play what you see, and you know, obviously when you got the ball, you need to, you know, you need to basically support each other, you know, possession, whatever. When you lose the ball, you know, get behind the ball and you know, mark players and, you know, whatever. So at the end of the day, forget about him. I mean, at the end of the day, if he ends up, you know, winning the World Cup and he's still the coach.
That's right. I can imagine his party. I can imagine the party and how he'll perform dancing at the party if it happened. Oh, mate, I want to be there when he's there. I've got to film the bastard. I've got to do something. Sorry for swearing, guys.
He's, he's caused a bit of a stir because he's a show pony.
He is.
You know, the way he reacts and the way he carries on the bench and what he says and the way he says things. And look, he's got everyone talking about him, and maybe that's his plan of attack.
And of course, Tony, what I will tell you too is that Mark Schwarzer interviewed him. And apparently got a headache, absolute headache interview. The guy is actually keeping a lot of things to himself. But, of course, you do play mind games at the World Cup, Tony. Of course, if Graham Arnold didn't play mind games at Qatar when you were there, I mean, this happens in these competitions, of course. You were in Qatar, you would have seen a lot of things.
Look, sometimes it does come down to mind games. It just depends on the opposition's coach as well. I mean, you look at Alan Stajic, he doesn't seem to play anything. He's just like a consummate professional, says all the right things, keeps to himself, doesn't say a lot, doesn't give away a lot. Sometimes when you're out there all the time as a personality, you've got to say a lot to cover a lot. But Alan doesn't say anything. Just, I don't know, there's an aura about him. And every team he goes to, you know, including Central Coast, Philippines, Matildas, he got results. And obviously, his motivational techniques are first class because he gets results. He got with the Philippines. He's turned what was a very ordinary team into something that was very proud of themselves. He's obviously put the pin from that role now. So whether he ends up back in the A League, maybe Perth Glory or something like that, I don't know.
It's on the cards. Yeah. It's on the cards, of course. But
I'd say services would be in demand.
Exactly. Unless someone pays for them, that's the other thing. They've got to buy them first. But let me just say now, Peter, how is it such a coincidence that we are playing Denmark exactly in this, just sort of like we played them, of course, in the group stage to actually make the next round at the Qatar World Cup to make the last 16. Now, the girls are playing in the last 16 actually against Denmark. So this is a very, and I'll tell you what, Tony, you saw that game last night. Where if England had lost that game, I'm sure we would have played against England. Is that right?
Yeah. Based on the other result, I think if the other team was the other two teams played were a draw, I think England would have still finished top. But I think there had to be a 2-goal difference. I think, but it doesn't matter. We're not playing them because what I saw last night, they were formidable.
So you think they're probably favourites as well, eh?
Oh, they'd be right up there. They were first class. They really were.
Now, I want to ask, Peter, yourself, Peter, is it better, would it be better to play England or would it have been better to play Denmark? I mean, we're talking about two European powerhouses here in the women's game. So the kids have got to step up.
Listen, we don't want to be playing England. England, like Tony said, and I watched the game last night, they're European champions. Mm-hmm. And they're not European champions for nothing, but I think they've improved since then. Because they're all over the park. They've got speed. They hold the ball. They've got players that can finish. Their defense is solid. I was really impressed watching them play. I was really impressed with England. And look, wouldn't we want to be playing England? We'd rather be playing Denmark. So we're okay playing Denmark. Let me tell you.
Oh boy. So now. Let me go back to Sam Kerr. He had her on the bench against, of course, against Canada. He had her there warming up and everything to go four goals up and not using her or giving her at least a couple of minutes time at the end. I thought he should have given her a few minutes, at least a few minutes to run a little bit out there. He never gave it enough.
You got me on the show about 3 weeks ago and I told you,
I know.
This injury will take 3 or 4 weeks.
I know. But they're saying different things.
I've had a calf injury in my time, and let me tell you, you don't want to be coming back early. If you come back early, you'll do it again. So there was no way. I mean, I don't know all the hype about her playing. I couldn't understand that. I couldn't understand that. I'm thinking, okay, is she going to play? But I think in the next game it's a possibility because it'll be now 4 weeks. It'll be yes. 4 weeks since we started. So I think next game she probably comes and plays off the bench.
Yes,
she probably won't start. But look, you know, we hope she comes, she plays, because she's a very important figure in that team, and with her, they, you know, obviously the chemistry is good with the other players. So she's an important cog in that Matilda side.
And also, Tony, it's been a massive surprise, the other girls stepping up, scoring goals. I mean, I've got Katie Russo. Oh, my God, man. Oh, my God. I couldn't believe it. The other girls have stepped up, and they've stepped up very well now in this game. And as Peter said, they may bring on in the next game for a couple of minutes, whatever. But the thing is, could he change the team that's actually performing now? That's the thing. I mean, getting a balance now of the girls playing the way they are, not giving away the ball as much as they did against Nigeria, and actually making very positive passes and everything, and scoring these goals. I tell you what, Tony, it's going to be hard to change, give much time to, I know, Sam Kerr. That's the thing, where Mary Fowler, and they're all sharing the goals around in positions.
Look, it's like Peter said, there's no way you'd bring her on even at the end of that game. Why would you bring her on? She'd do it again when we're 4-0 up. So I'd probably go with the same lineup. They proved themselves. The chemistry seemed to be there. And if Sam's needed, she comes on. But, yeah, it wouldn't have been worth risking you, that's for sure. But if we can turn on a performance like that with the way they played, and their confidence will obviously be up, they can do a job. They'll be in front of a massive crowd again, and it's a home crowd. So, you know, all the little boxes are ticked in our favour for that. So Sam can come on as a weapon, I guess, but I definitely wouldn't be starting her. You wouldn't risk anyone from the get-go, because she will be targeted. Look, if she starts, she'll be targeted. But when she comes off the bench, we'll already know what the situation will be in at the time. So if we're up, great. I mean, if we are up, say, 2-0, he may not even risk her in that as well. He'll probably give her another week. And like Peter said, with 4 weeks, I spoke to Joe Mullen on the weekend, and he was saying the same thing, you know, depending on the severity of an injury like that, you know, anywhere between, you know, 4 to 6 weeks, depending on the tear. So, yeah, there's no way she was going to play. But then again, you know, he's using her as another psychological battle. Will she or won't she play, even though we know she wasn't? But the other coach is not going to know that. The other players are going to be fearing her coming on. So, again, just use her psychological advantage, even if she's not going to play a part.
And that's exactly what he's doing, Peter. He's doing a psychological thing. Will I or won't I? He's not answering the questions or things. And if these mind games work, so be it. It's that type of competition, a World Cup, where you could use you know, what he's like, and we know what he's like. But if he, you know, and the thing about this is, I'm wondering what's going to happen on Monday. We can't do the show Monday night, but against Denmark, we still are playing against girls who are really highly rated. That's the thing about this. We may have, if you've seen England, you've seen England, Tony. What else have you seen about England that makes you think that they could win it, or could we play them in the final?
Well, I think when you look at that Lauren James last night, those goals she scored were, I mean, especially that last goal that went in, that was just absolute class away. But just an angled volley. The cross was awesome to start with, but the way she just angled it into the opposite side of the goal. But I was on the eastern side of Hindmarsh Stadium, and we had a really good view of everything, and their passing, their weight of passing, their drawing of players. Every time a Chinese player went to the ball, there was another player rushing in with intent. You could see that they were, if you touch that ball, you're going. And they played with such aggression, but they were, every time the Chinese players touched the ball, there was someone on them straight away. And they forced errors time and time again. I think it was 17 shots to 7. You know, it's they totally dominated, but it was their speed, their aggression, their passing. Even when they pass the ball back, they go forward, then they just switch the ball back and just open up the middle of the midfield all over again, and then just find holes every single time. I'm glad we're not playing them start up. I'd rather play them in the final, or maybe the knockout game before the final. Because I think they'll go far. You know, I think if we're going to make a four, they'll be in the four. Yeah. I'll be shocked if they're not.
Now, Peter, go on, Peter.
I agree, Tony.
Now, Peter, do we keep the same team, the same setup, same everything? Does he keep the same thing against Denmark? Or does he need to make changes, being a much more, I think they're more of a – but the other thing I will tell you about this is that
– He's going to He's going to keep the same lineup.
And what I saw against Canada, they are a bit more aggressive in more physical. The girls are more physical as well, which they changed a bit on that. To say that the way they played against Nigeria and playing against Canada, that was two different teams. Two different teams completely.
Yeah, because look, they had to win. The game was a draw, wasn't good. No. So they fought hard for the win. They tackled. They got stuck in there. They were hungry. And look, they're going to bring that same attitude for the next game. I looked at Denmark. I think we can beat Denmark. It's going to be a tough game. It's not going to be an easy game, but I think they can beat Denmark. They just got to basically step it up, increase the intensity, be disciplined, hold the ball, possession. I said from day one, possession, that's going to be the key. And you see the English team, the way they pass the ball around, like Tony said, they're so crisp. They just hold the ball. So, they're so comfortable on the ball. And Australia needs to do that, needs to do the same. They've got to basically not give it away as easy as they've done in the past.
Exactly.
That's my opinion.
And as we saw against Nigeria, gave the ball that many times away and they scored against us. The possession, like you said, Peter, is very important. And against Denmark, the possession must come up the same way as we played against Canada. I was very surprised, and I said the Olympic champions, it was like a revenge type of thing where we got beaten by them at the Olympics and now we came back and beat them. So, that we thought that they were favourites as well, but they're not. That's the thing. We're not going to do this show for too long, guys, tonight. And I'll tell you what's happening right now. You're not going to believe this, guys. Our third gentleman, Carlos Bielli, he's picked up tickets to every bloody game in Sydney. Every game. And every time I want to get him on, he's going to be there at the game on Monday. He will be at the game on Monday to watch the Matildas and, of course, Denmark. So your last thoughts on the game the Denmark game is very important. If we win this one, we go to the semi-finals and then we see what happens, Tony.
Half Carlos's luck.
Mate, is luck all right?
Mate, tell Carlos my daughter wants two tickets. I want two tickets.
I'm going to give you his number. I'll give you his number for sure. That's for sure. Don't forget, he's high up in the law thing, so he can say a few things out there and get tickets. I'm not going to say anymore. You get stuck into me.
Allegedly.
that's the thing about that. So, Peter, Tony?
For Charlotte Grant from Adelaide United too, South Australian girl, for her debut as well.
Fantastic.
Good to see her get the gig.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and right near the end. So that was good. So, it's going to be very interesting, and it's good because we're showing that we can match it physically. I think if we do end up playing England, I think you'll find an extremely physical game because they will try to rough us up, but we've got some girls that can rough others up as well. Katrina Gorey, she'd get in there and smack the rest of them. So, I'm looking forward to it. It's been quite exciting so far. I mean, that the FIFA boss came out yesterday and said we've put on the best Women's World Cup so far. Whether that's just lip service or not, I don't know. But, I mean, if he's going to make comments like that, well, then give us the bloody men's as well.
That's right. I agree, mate. Give us the men's World Cup.
We have we have a lot of things here. We've got a couple of things come up from everybody else as well here. There's a few people here saying the cup stays in Nicholas Vassos says the cup stays in Australia. Joe Italiano says France are looking good tonight. Some guys are saying the Matildas to win the cup. Well, it's pretty positive out there. So, as I said, the whole weight of the nation's on their shoulders. And I'm thinking that this is the pressure that's coming from these girls to perform. I mean, of course, they want to go one better than the Socceroos, even go two times better than the Socceroos. Can they make the finals, Peter? Last one. Can they make a final?
Yeah, look, they can go along deep into the tournament. But look, they need, like I said, they need to improve. They need to improve. Looking at some of these other teams, Sweden. England, Germany, they're strong sides. They're all over the park. Australia needs to improve. Look, they can. They've got the players. They've just got to lift. And if they keep improving, well, it's 11v11 there. Anything can happen.
Exactly. So this is the thing, guys. Don't forget Monday night. It's going to be at 8 p.m. at where it's going to be at Homebush. I hear it's going to be at Homebush or the other stadium in Sydney. You would know, Peter. Yeah, you got to get tickets, of course, to be there.
Mate, it's going to be in Sydney. It's going to be Homebush. The demand is incredible. The intensity and the demand for tickets for that game is like, oh, my God, everyone wants to go to this game. So it's going to be – it's a sellout already.
We have
But you just can't get tickets.
Can't believe it. We have never seen.
I'm asking for tickets,
Carlos. I'll be speaking to Carlos tomorrow. Don't worry. I'll ask him a few things. But let me say, we have never seen anything like this. To see how many people are going to these games, Peter and Tony. Are we waking up? Has the country woken up to the sleeping giant? I want to know. Will we wake up, Tony? Is it going to happen now?
Well, I keeping an eye on the tabs, obviously, with Angela Baker posting some of the the viewing results. Got to remember, too, those viewing results are like Channel 7. I'd love to see the overseas viewing votes from the other country. I'd love to see also Federation Square and other squares that have. I'd like to see the numbers that are there. So for the vision I've seen has been outstanding. I'm praying to God that we can win it, because I think the sleeping giant will get a kick in the arse, not a little prod. So. And politicians will have to take notice, because even now, a lot of clubs, especially in Adelaide, they're getting inquiries about young girls wanting to start playing. And that's going to explode from any other state as well at the end of it. We don't have the demand. Sorry, we have the demand. We don't have the facilities to cater for it. And that's going to make politicians take note. And I'm just praying to God that we do win it, because I really believe that the sleeping giant will, we'll be definitely out there, and the media will have to take notice, because they won't be able to ignore it any longer. So we still cop the negatives in the press. Obviously, you read articles and they always seem to pick the little nitbits out of it rather than concentrating on the real positives. So this will shut them up if we can do the job.
On a sad note, Peter, the New Zealand girls have bowed out. They've been eliminated. So that's very sad for them as well, being one of the hosts of the World Cup as well. They gave it a big go. They gave it a good go, and apparently a massive interest in the game in New Zealand again too, which is good for them. So fantastic. And I hope that this is a prelude to a World Cup for us in this country, a big men's World Cup. And I'm sure this is a massive test. And we should have had that World Cup a few months ago, 6 months ago. We should have had it here. But, things go wrong in some places. Pockets open up. Things under the table, and that usually happens. So we hope to see the next World Cup. Peter, if it was here, how good it would have been here, Peter. How good would that have been here?
We can only pray. But unfortunately, like you said, it's, all these, funny business that happens in football. It happens everywhere.
Yeah. I know. We know what the game's all about too.
Especially right at the top, mate. So it's very sad.
But some guys went to jail for that reason too, but that's the best thing that happened about it too, but we'll fix it up. Guys, thank you tonight for this review. We got a lot of people watching tonight. It's fantastic. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Tony. Of course, this is a song for Mary Fowler. We want you to score more goals, please, Mary. There you go, love. This song's for you. There you go. Check it out. She bangs again for Mary, guys. Good night, gentlemen. Thank you for joining me on this Lily Show. Thank you, Peter, and of course, Tony from Adelaide. Thanks, guys. You want to enjoy the song and stay with me and enjoy the song. You want to dance with me. Carlos, not into dance right now, but I'll have to do something about it.
give me some tickets.
I'll talk to Carlos.
All right.
Tomorrow we'll talk to you. Bye. Thanks, guys. Thank you for joining me, guys. Thank you, guys. Hey. It's up to me. Tell me your name. You blow me up. Cloud, it's all the same. Yeah, let the ticking, now you're ticking away like a bomb. Mary, keep going, our goals. Talk to me, give me a sign. You're switching sides like a Gemini. You're playing games and now you're hitting my heart like a drum. Yeah, baby. Well, if it's lady luck, get you on my mind. We're gonna rock this town alive. I better up me up till she knocks me out. She walks and she talks like Mary Fowler. She bangs, she bangs. Come on, guys. Don't forget, next week we'll have a special show again. We hope the Matildas win on Monday night. And we'll be back for a little review show as well on that. And hopefully they're in the semi-finals. Good night, guys. See you next week sometime. We'll let you know what's going on. Thank you. Good night, guys. Thank you. Football, this is live tonight. Check it out, guys. Check it out. Thank you.
Hi guys, Harry Sunday here, letting you know that there's a apparel company that supports the game that you love. It's called There Is Only One Football.com, guys. They've got all sorts of stuff, from caps, t-shirts, water bottles, all sorts of accessories, even for your mobile phone, all that sporting stuff you can wear anywhere you want to wear it, guys. That's right. And don't forget the website it's on, thereisonlyonefootball.com.
Check it out. If you're listening right now, I've got some great news for you guys. Some people won't be happy. Some people will be happy. Some people won't be happy. You got your opinions. That's fine. Here we go. Check it out. Hey, the cup of life. This is the one. Now is the time. Don't ever stop. We shouldn't know. Gotta be strong. We shouldn't know. Right from the top. And when you feel the heat, the world is at your feet. No one can hold you back if you really want it. Here we go. I see it in your eyes. You want the cup of life. Not the days. Here you're gonna get it. Do you really want it? Tell me right now, people. Here we go. Ale, ale, ale. Go, go, go. Ale, ale, ale. Tonight's the night. We're gonna celebrate. Here we go. We are the people. We are the passion. We are the history. We come from the NSL, and that's where the NSL is right now, guys. We're going to be back in the NSL very shortly, guys. Thank you, guys. Right now, I just thought I'd come online. If you listen to me right now, guys, I thought I've come online because I got some great news today, and a lot of people aren't going to be happy, of course. I'm just going to make sure a couple of people get on right now. As you can see, we have a brand new system here. It's looking fantastic. You may be seeing on my right, on my left-hand side, on my right-hand side, I think it is, FA opens expressions of interest for a national football second tier. As far as I'm concerned, it is an NSL. It's an NSL. As you can see, these clubs, these boys on the front here, they're former NSL clubs, guys. Of course, you can see one of the South Melbourne captains there, of course. I'm not going to mention names, but I'm just going to make sure that I get this message out today so everyone can listen to what's happening. And we are putting our hands up. Yes, footballers are putting their hands up to get involved in the NSL, or the second tier, if you want to call it that, guys. We want to be involved. We are talking to people about this, and hopefully it's going to be an amazing journey through the NSL, guys, well, second tier, if you want to call that as well. So let me just get onto the other site there to actually post some stuff so people can actually listen to this as well. I'd like to read a few little things from the excerpt on the news as well, guys. So as you can see, our sponsors, CCD Lawyers, and There Is Only One Football. Don't forget, guys, as you can see, my left-hand side, right-hand side, these are fantastic shirts that were worn by the NSL clubs. We're hoping that they wear them in the second division. It's the second coming. As far as I'm concerned, as the NSL, you can scream as much as you like, guys, but they're the clubs that made the game. They're the clubs that actually were the foundation clubs of the first competition, national competition in this country, and that's what we're looking for right now. So if you clubs are looking at these shirts, There Is Only One Football, Of course, the thereisonlyonefootball.com on the bottom there, guys. If you want to get on there and you want to talk to someone about getting these shirts as supporters for your second division or the second NSL coming of the NSL, they're available now, guys, on There's Only One Football. That's where they're available. I'm just going right now to the former supporter sites to put this information up as well. We've got the information up. So if you're listening right now, please check out these shirts. You can buy them online. There is only one football, guys. Have a look at these amazing shirts, guys. You will not find this quality anywhere. So get on. There's only one football, guys. So I'm just getting on to our